B-flat harmonica. Let's just talk about one of the lines to get you going in this song, I've Gotta Be With You Tonight by Slim Harpo. This comes from the Accello Singles Anthology. Highly recommend that because there's like over 40 tracks of Slim Harpo's hits. And this one's really cool because he didn't record much third position that I'm aware of. I can think of one right now. But other than that, this is the only one that sticks out in my mind. And if you're new to third position, it's perfect to learn because it's just right in front of your face. The riff is just so easy to grab. And I'm doing this topic because Saturday I'll be teaching a class on Raining in My Heart and Baby Scratch My Back by Slim Harpo. So if you want to join me on Saturday for that at 11 a.m. Central, I'll put ticket information in the video description. Right now, I want to talk about this song. So I'm going to play a little bit with him because copyright stuff. I can't just play the track by itself. All right, let's talk about the primary notes of the riff. Pretty cool. All scale notes. Not every single scale note, but all the notes being played are scale notes. 8 draw. 7 blow. 6 draw. 5 draw. And 4 draw. These notes are the only notes you need to play it, doubling up on that 8 draw to start. And then 7 blow. Works best tongue blocked here. 6 draw. And then 5 draw, 4 draw. It's all about the cadence that you and the rhythm you're putting to this. The 4 draw, actually he plays a 1-4 draw, like a tremolo pulse. It's really a vibrato, I suppose. On that. The very first pass, he actually brings in that octave with a little bit of 3 draw. Let me try to recreate that. Like that. The second time, he does not. So it's very intuitive to find out when he moves to the 4 chord the next phrase. Sounds like that, but basically to give you a heads up, he's staying, and I'll put the link to this song if I can find it on YouTube. I'll put it in the video description, but for the 4 chord, he's pretty much living in the split octave embouchure. And instead of me just giving you the answer and saying this is what he's playing, just play it with me slowly or try to identify it by just listening at first. Maybe I should double check. Yep. Here it is as a single note version. Let me just let you hear that in case you need that. Just right off holes, 4 through 6, but this is in a split position, an octave, so split there and an octave here. And so it's a beautiful one to learn. It's just got a cool vibe to it. There was something else I was listening to today. I'm not going to be able to find it right here. If I do, I'll link it in the video description. But there's another really unusual first position. Here it is. I found it. I Love the Life I'm Living is a B-flat harmonica, but he's using it in first position. Totally unique playing from Slim. If you haven't heard that one, check it out. I'll leave it a mystery until you hear it, but it's a great one for working on tongue blocking, single notes, and just, you know, working on that beautiful textured play. Something like that. It sounds like that. Yeah, it's like one of those, you know, I want to say it's like a 1-5 type of thing. Anyway, it's a cool one to check out. Get into some of this more obscure Slim Harpo. There are plenty of songs that people don't talk about. And often that's where the the sweetest ones are found is the not the big hits like Raining in My Heart and Baby Scratch My Back, but these other kind of more obscure tunes. I'm excited for Saturday because in these classes, while I think some of the folks attend and they're like, I know this song, I can kind of play this already or learn it by ear, I'm there to kind of give you my take on how you can alter these lines in a very natural way and build in your own texture so that you can put your own little original twist to them. You know what I mean? And it's cool to sometimes do things exact as they were recorded, but I kind of prefer to just put your own little thing on it, you know, make it your own. And I'm not the only one that thinks this, but I think it's a nice way to separate it so that when people hear you perform it, they hear it and they go, oh yeah, that's definitely Raining in My Heart, but he's got his own way of doing it. He's using something a little different. I've now come across four different versions of it. Something from 1961, 1964, one that was recorded between 69 and 70, and then another one. I'm getting no pun intended, swamped with the swamp blues. I'm getting swamped with these versions. And the version I'll be teaching just is going to be focusing on, here, I'll play it for you. Well, I can't really play it for you, but I got to kind of make some noise over this. So I'll be doing this version where Slim hits the hard stops at the end of each phrase, and then the next pass he holds the long notes. That way you get to hear both sides of it. In one of the versions, he just plays long notes throughout at the end of each phrase. This one, he switches it up. The version that I spoke of that somebody just sent me through email recently, 1969 to 70, that he recorded in a studio in Baton Rouge called the Deep South, I think. This version is cool because he takes solo. He goes off towards the end, he's just playing a solo. And usually, you know, when Slim's playing and these recordings that we have, you just hear, you know, you're mainly getting his melodic approach and sort of insertion of riff, and it lives in the song. You don't just hear him go off in solo very often. So I really love that version that somebody sent to me. I had not heard it before. So that's what I got today. I hope that you guys make it a great day, and I hope that I'll see some of you on Saturday for class. If not, I'll catch you in a video really soon. Make it a good one.